हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कंटिन्यू एक्सरसाइज 5.3, दैट इज पार्ट 3 एंड द क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. फाइंड द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट 15 मल्टीपल्स ऑफ 8. वी हैव टू फाइंड द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट 15 मल्टीपल्स ऑफ 8. मीन्स वी हैव गिवन 15 मल्टीपल्स ऑफ 8. मीन्स फर्स्ट इज 8, देन 16, 24 एंड सो ऑन अप टू 15 टर्म्स. सो हियर A1 as 8, A2 as 16, so D will be A2 minus A1, that is 16 minus 8, so this become 8. So we have D as 8 and N as 15, A as 8. So now we have to find sum. So now as N will be N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Now S15, so S15 will be 15 by 2 into 2A, means 2 into A, that is 8, plus N minus 1, that is 15 minus 1 into D, that is 8. So S15 will be 15 by 2 into 16 plus 15 minus 1 becomes 14 into 8. 15 by 2, 16 plus 14, 8 is 112. So 15 by 2, 16 plus 112 becomes 128. Now 15 by 2 into 128. 2 6 ja 12, 2 4 ja 8. So 15 into 64 becomes 15 4 ja 60 and 15 6 90 and 9 60. So this becomes 960. So the sum of first 15 multiples of 8 is 960. Thus we can say, thus sum of first 15 multiples of 8 is 960. Pause the video and note it down. In the next problem, that is question number 14, we are to find the sum of odd numbers between 0 and 50. So the odd numbers between 0 and 50 are 1, 3, 5, dash dash up to 49. Here A1 is 1, A2 is 3, so D will be A2 minus A1, that is 3 minus 1, it becomes 2. So D we have 2. An as 49, A1 as 1, so we need to find the sum. So we, first of all, we have to find N. So by using an as a plus n minus 1 into d, so an we have as 49, a as 1, n minus 1 will remain same, as we have to find the number of terms, so n will remain same and d is 2. So 49 minus 1 equals to n minus 1 into 2, so this become 48 equals to n minus 1 into 2, or we can write it as n minus 1 equals to 48 upon 2. 224 to 48, so n will be equals to 24 plus 1, or n equals to 25. So now we have number of terms as 25. So now sum of 25 terms will be n by 2, means 25 by 2 into a plus an, that is a is we have 1 plus n is 25, so this will become 25 by 2 into a plus an, that is 49, sorry, an is 49, so this becomes 20, 49 plus 1 becomes 50, so 25 to 50, this become 25 into 25 becomes 625, so S25 will become 625. Thus the sum of odd numbers between 0 and 50 is 625. Pause the video and note it down. So in the next problem, that is question number 15, a contract on a construction job specifies for a delay of completion beyond a certain date as follows: rupees 200 for the first day, rupees 250 for the second day, and rupees 300 for the third day, etc. The penalty for each succeeding day being rupees 50 more than for the preceding day, how much penalty the contractor has to pay as penalty if he has delayed the work for by 30 days. Means we have to find the total penalty that he has to pay after 30 days. Means n equals to 30 days we have given. And the first term that is 200. So A is 200. And next day that is 250. So that D will be 50 rupees. So we have, we can say we have the progression as follows. Rupees 200, rupees 250, rupees 300, up to 30 days means 30 terms. So here A1 as, I'm not using unit, so I have A1 as 200, A2 as 250, so therefore D will be A2 minus A1. This becomes 250 minus 200, and now D is 50, and N is 30. Now we have A as 200, D as 50, and N as 30. So now we can find Sn. So Sn will be N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So now put all the values in this relation. So S30 would be 30 upon 2, 2 into A, that is 2 into 200, plus N minus 1, that is 30 minus 1, into D, that is 50. Now, this become 15 into 400 plus 39 into 50. Solve it. 15 into 400 plus 0, 59 is 45. This will be 5315 and 1950. This will become 1950. Recheck. 0, 5, 45, this will 5, 3, 15 or 14, so 1950, sorry, 30 minus 1 becomes 29 into 50, so this will be 145, so 1450, and now this become 1450 plus 400 becomes 1850, now 0, 15, 5 is 75, this become 127 and this become 27, so 27,750 rupees will be the total penalty that the contractor has to pay. So pause the video and note it down. In the next problem, that is question number 16, a sum of rupees 700 is to be used to give 7 cash prizes to the students of a school for their overall academic performance. If each prize is rupees 20 less than its preceding prize, find the value of each prize. So let the first prize, let the first prize to be A. So the progression would be as followed. First prize is A, so next prize will be 20 less than its preceding prize, so this will become A minus 20, then 20 less than this price, so A minus 40 and up to 7 terms. We have to distribute 7 prizes, so 7 terms. Here, A1 is A, D is minus 20, as each price is 20 less than its preceding, so D is minus 20 and N is 7. So now we have to find, and Sn we have given 700. So that is S7. So S7 can be written as 7 by 2 into 2A, that is 2 into A is, we have A plus N minus 1, that is 7 minus 1 into D, that is minus 20 equals to 700. So 7 by 2 into 2A plus 6 minus 120 equals to 700. 2A minus 120 equals to 700 into 2 by 7. This 7 by 2 will be reciprocal on transposing to the right hand side, and this becomes 100 into 2 becomes 200. So now we have 2A minus 120 equals to 200. So 2A will be 200 plus 120, and this will be 320, and A will be 320 upon 2. This becomes 160. Thus the first prize is 160. Thus the 7 prizes would be as fallout. First price is 160, so next price will be 20 rupees less than this, so this become 140, 120, 100, 80, 60, and next one is 40. These are the prices given to the 7 students. So pause the video and note it down. So in the next problem, that is question number 17, in a school, students thought of planting trees in and around the school to reduce the air pollution. It was decided that the number of trees that each class of each section of each class will plant will be the same as the class in which they are studying. For example, a section class 1 will plant 1 tree and a section of class 2 will plant 2 trees and so on till class 12. There are 3 sections of each class. How many trees will be planted by the students? As there are 3 sections of each class, so the progression would be as followed, or we can say total planted tree, total planted trees will be as followed: 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to 12, that as we have 12 classes, but each class has 3 sections, so we will multiply each term by 3, so the progression will be 3, 6 plus 9 and so on, and in the end we have 36. So here A1 is 3, A2 is 6, therefore D will be A2 minus A1, that is 6 minus 3, so D will be 3. And AN we can directly see here, so AN is 36, so and N is, and or we can say N is 12, as we have 12 classes. So now total planted tree will be as 12 will be equals to 12 by 2 into 2 A plus AN, we can say A plus AN directly, so there is no need of T. So A, that is 3, plus AN, that is 36. So 2, 6, 12, so 6 into 36 plus 3 becomes 39, and 39 into 6 becomes 234. 6, 9 is 54, you can see, and 5, 6 is 18, and 5, 23, so 234. So total planted tree will be 234. Thus, we can say, thus, number of planted trees are 234. Pause the video and note it down. So in the next problem, that is question number 18, a spiral is made up of successive semicircles with the centers alternatively at A and B, starting with center A at of radii is 0.5 cm, 1 cm, 1.5 cm, and as shown on figure, you can see this one. So we'll start with center A and assuming radius as 0.5 cm. Then this is the first semicircle, then second semicircle, then third, then fourth, up to 13 semicircles we have to move. So what is the total length of such a spiral made up of 13 semicircles? We have to find out the length of 13 semicircles. So let the length of 13 semicircles to be L1, L2, L3 and up to L13. So here we have length of first semicircle, that is L1, we can say L1 equals to, as the semicircle we are using, not circle, so length will be pi r1 we can say, and that is pi, and r we have 0.5 cm, so this become 0.5 pi cm. This is L1, we have L1 as 0.5 pi cm. So now length of second semicircle, that is L2, would be pi r2, so pi into, that is 1.0 cm, so this become pi centimeter. Similarly, length of third semicircle would be, semicircle that is L3 would be pi R3. So that is pi into 1.5 centimeter. This become 1.5 pi centimeter. Thus we can say, thus from these terms, an AP will be formed as followed. You can see that is 0.5 pi, 1 pi, 1.5 pi, and up to 13 terms. So here A1 is 0.5 pi, A2 is 1 pi, so D will be A2 minus A1, and that is 1 pi minus 0.5 pi, and this becomes 0.5 pi. So D is 0.5 pi. Now we have A as 0.5 pi, D as 0.5 pi, N as 13. So total length of 13 semicircle would be as 13, that is equals to 13 by 2 into 2 into A, that is 0.5 pi, plus N minus 1, that is 13 minus 1, into D, that is again 0.5 pi. So this become 13 by 2 into 0.5 into 2 becomes 1 pi, plus 13 minus 1 becomes 12 into 0.5 can be written as 5 by 10, or we can say 0.5 will remain same. So this will be as like 13 by 2 into pi plus 12 into 0.5 becomes 12 5 is 60, so decimal will be after 6, that is 6.0 pi. We can say 6.0 pi. So now 13 by 2 into 6 pi plus 1 pi becomes 7 pi. Now 13 by 2 into 7 pi, that is pi can be written as 22 by 7. So 7 will be cancelled and 2 11 jar 22. So 13 into 11 becomes 143. So sum of 13 semicircles, so length of 13 semicircles, sum of length of 13 semicircles would be 143 centimeter. Pause the video and note it down. In the next problem, that is question number 19, 200 logs are stacked in the following manner such that 20 logs in the bottom row, 19 in the next row, 18 in the row next to it, and so on. In how many rows are 200 logs placed and how many logs are in the top row? Now we have to find the number of rows of the logs and the number of logs in the topmost row. So here we have, or we can say we have an progression, like we have a progression as follows, that is A1, A2, A3 and up to AN. We can say we have to find N. So here even the 20 logs are placed in the first row, in the next row 19 logs are placed, and third row 18 logs are placed, and so on. So here, and total rows are, logs are 200. So here A1 is 20 and A2 is 19, and we have given already SN, that is 200 logs. So we need to find N. So therefore D will be A2 minus A1, that is 19 minus 20, and become minus 1. So D is minus 1, and A is 20, and SN is 200. So now we will use the relation SN equals to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. That is SN equals to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So SN we have 200 logs, N we are to find 2A. In the first row there is 20 logs, so we can put A as 20, and the next N minus 1 will remain same, and D is minus 1. So solve this relation. So 200 equals to N by 2 into 2 into 20 becomes 40, N minus 1, minus 1 becomes minus N, and plus 1. So 200 equals to N by 2 into 40 plus 1 becomes 41 minus N. Now this 2 will be transposed to the left hand side and become 400, and n into 41 minus n. Open the bracket. So 400 equals to n into 41 becomes 41n, n into n becomes n square, plus minus becomes minus. Or we can write this relation as n square minus 41n plus 400 equals to 0. Now, by using midterm splitting method, we are to find the solution of this equation, that is n. Find the value, we have to find the value of n. So we will have to break b, that is minus 41, into such numbers that their sum becomes minus 41 and their product becomes a and c, that is a is 1, so and c is 400, so become their sum, their product becomes 400. So we will have to factorize 400 to find such numbers. So 200, now 2, this become 100, and 2 become 50, and 2 becomes 25, and this next one 5 is 25, and the next one 5 is 5. So we have to find such that two numbers such that their sum becomes minus 41 and their product becomes 400. So we have 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, and 5 is 25. So we have two numbers, 25 and 16. Both are negative, so as we are to take their product as positive, so both numbers will be negative. So minus 25 and minus 16, we can say n square minus 25n minus 16n plus 400 equals to 0. Now take n as common from first these two terms, so n into n minus 25 minus 16 into n minus 25 equals to 0, and minus 25 into n minus 16 equals to 0. So this implies we can say either n minus 25 equals to 0 or n minus 16 equals to 0. So we have n equals to 25 or n equals to 16. So let us check both the value are applicable or not. So we need to find the 25th term. So a 25 equals to a plus 24 into d, and a, that is 20 logs in the first row, and 24, and d is minus 1. So 20 minus 24, and this become minus 4. So in the 25th row, there are minus 4 logs, and that is not a natural number. Log can't be negative. So this doesn't belong to natural number. So this value of n becomes rejected. So this will be rejected. So now let us check a 16, that is a plus 15d. So a is 20 and 15 into d is minus 1. So this become 20 minus 15 and this become 5. So there are 16 rows in that stack, and in the last stack or in the last row of the stack there are 5 logs. So thus there are total 16 rows and 5 logs in the top row. 5 logs in the top row. So pause the video and note it down. In the next problem, that is question number 20, in a potato race, a bucket is placed at the starting point, which is 5 meters from the first potato, and the other potatoes are placed 3 meters apart in a straight line. There are 10 potatoes in the line. So you can see from the figure, here is the bucket, and the first potato is 5 meter distance from the bucket, and next potatoes are placed at 3 meter distance from each other. So a competitor starts from the bucket, picks the nearest potato and runs back with it and drop it in the bucket, runs back to the pick of the next potato and runs to the bucket to drop it in the bucket, and C continues in the same way until all the potatoes are in the bucket. So what is the total distance competitor has to run? So simply we can see from the figure, the total distance covered would be, for the first potato, it will be 5 and 5. 5 C run from bucket to potato and potato to bucket. Similarly for the next steps. So we can see we have our total distance covered by the competitor would be, for the first kilometer it will be 2 into 5 plus, for second potato, it will be 5 plus 3. And for the third, it will be 2 into 5 plus 3 plus 3 and so on up to 10 terms, as we have 10 potatoes. So 2 into 5 becomes 10 plus 5 plus 3 becomes 8, 8 to the 16, so this will be 16, and 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 3, 11 into 2 becomes 22, and up to 10 terms, as we have 10 potatoes. So the computer has to run 10 times. So here, you can see here, A1 is 10, A2 is 16, and N is 10. So therefore, D will be A2 minus A1, that is 16 minus 10, this becomes 6. So we have D as 6, N as 10, and A as 10. So total distance covered to pick the 10 potatoes would be as 10 upon 10 by 2 into 2A, that is 2 into 10 plus N minus 1, that is 10 minus 1 into D, that is 6. So this will be 2, 5 to 10. So here it will be 5, 2 into 10 becomes 20, plus 10 minus 1 becomes 9, 9 6 is 54. So 5 into 20 plus 54 becomes 74. So this will be 5, 4 to 20, and here 5, 7 to 35, and 2, 37. So total distance covered by the competitor to pick the 10 potatoes would be 370 meter. So pause the video and note it down. And this is all about the exercise 5.3. And in the next video, we will continue the next topic. So till then, keep watching.